luscious judges. You read about them on Facebook, now you get to see them in the flesh. The first one we have is Mrs. DuPoint. Mrs. DuPoint, you may remember her from wearing that lovely couture from Target. Remember the blinds? She saw it in the window and she just had to have it. Yeah. What, Nordstrom? I don't remember. She is married to the late John DuPoint. He's not deceased, just perpetually late. Give it up for Mrs. DuPoint. Our next judge is Tyler T. Love. The resident campaigner in the St. Cloud area. He has a passion for West Coast fashion and for his pets. Thank you very much for coming down. He has been thrilled. I asked him, could you come to this? He's like, oh yeah. Usually you have to check on people just to kind of make sure. But yeah, he's been, yeah. It's gonna be fun. And then last but not least, the talented, the wonderful, the ever fabulous Miss D. Richards. D has a whole bunch of titles. D is fabulous. We're not gonna talk about her much, but you're gonna see more of her later. Tips, we'll go over that a little bit more, and I think there's going to be some way to demonstrate, we'll see. But anyway, I'm going to turn the stage back over to Miss Albertini so we can see the ladies. Thank you very much.
Yes. Alrighty, first up, without further ado, please give it up. Radiant, is that a thing that we can use to describe this one? Let's just give it up for Miss Julie Andrews. My ability to even has escaped me just now. She says her height is 173 centimeters. Her weight says 8 stone and not a pebble more. Her handwriting is almost as hard to read as her humor. Her hair color says depends on the role. It's time to find Mary Poppins over here. Her eye color is blue. Do we? Keep walking, try it. Show those cakes. Show the judges you love them. That's a man, Maury. Miss Julie is going to choose two questions. She's going to read them to herself. Then she's going to hand them to me, and I will read them to you. At which point, she will give us an answer. Physical attributes,
or my best physical attribute, I do say, probably my legs.
Oh, they're lovely.
They're so lovely. I really enjoy them.
Who's got a drink or a shot? I am too sober for this one right now. I mean tea, or whatever. We got it, folks. I'm going home. I mean, I have no idea why this would even be a question.
I've
never heard such a thing in my life.
I'm not sure either.
How do you handle it when a bison starts nuzzling your privates? The shade is real tonight. Oh, God bless you.
That's how she handles it. That is how she handles it, yes. Well, my fair lady, I can even. So,
You know, that's probably the best answer I've ever heard.
Whatever I do, darling, I do it with class. So, thank you, man.
That hair definitely says class. Don't you think, ladies and gentlemen? Class with three K's. Get off my stage. It just shows about you. Next to the stage, straight out of Cooter County, give it up for the one and only, thank God there's only one, Tank Hooray Macrochet. Miss Tank Hooray is 5'13". Her weight says I never do. Hair color, sorry I'm allergic to rabbits. Eye color, yes I do. She's a bright one. That hair is something else. Well, give us your best one way with your stoli bottle hanging out of your lips. Your hair, it reminds me of something. It reminds me of something I pulled out of a drain this morning. Talk about road hard and boy wet. Jesus. The catastrophe is strong in this one. Are you ready for your questions?
My what?
Put your hand in here, you know how to do that. And take two pieces of paper. Those are the white squares. Now read it to yourself, and then hand it to me. And then I'll ask you that question. And so help me God if there's anything about animal sex. If you are the lucky winner, what do you intend to do with your title?
World peace.
And if you would choose another little white square. On phonics works for me. Choose a judge to help you tuck. Who and why?
Tyler Tootsie Roll. Because it's like a Tootsie Roll and he knows a lot about them.
Alright, everybody give it up for Tankeray Macrochet. Train wrecks or something, watch that go by. And we've come to our final contestant. Everyone, please give it up for Mad Madam Cox. How does that Kate even remotely support all that ass? Miss Madam Cox is 6 foot tall. Her weight says depends on the load. I don't know which load you might be referring to. Maybe the one that's apparently in your hair. Her hair color changes.
I have to sun it up now.
Her eye color, piercing. Like staring your dead soul. How did you get out of the home? That's my question. Can we leave your cage unlocked? Now I need you to step over here to this nice man with the little box. Shove your hand in his box. You know how to do that, I know you do. Take out a little piece of paper. What?
1934, Mad Love with Charles Schulz. That's how I became the inspiration for Snoopy.
So you did a zombie style.
Versus Donatello Versace. Who wins and why?
First of all, I read the questions. I need to figure out how this works. Try to take my job.
Which one's gonna go next, dearie? Me? Okay. Well, I've always liked the Tammy Faye. You know, she's got the eyes to God, and they go up, and they go up. So definitely Tammy Faye, because that kind of tell it's a whore.
And you're a good Christian woman, aren't you? You know, we always say the higher the hair, the closer to God, but that hair looks like it's from hell. Who is the inspiration for your drag persona? And if you say to me, I swear to God.
Well, I was telling the girls at the home that every once in a while, you just have to look out around you, and everyone's my inspiration, because we all get all bitches.
You remind me of somebody. An old somebody. He works in Uptown. You probably don't know him. Everyone, please give it up for Madam Cox. Jesus. Alright, so for just about 10 minutes now, we're going to go take a cocktail break so it's easier for you to part with your dollar bills and so that we all look better, and God knows they need it. So go drink up, tip your bartenders, we'll be back in 10 minutes.
I might be drastic, but I think I'm fantastic.